Have you ever wondered what it would take to actually just bend light like a solid object?
Yeah, me too. Welcome to Impossible Science.
Hey guys, it's Jason Latimer, the world champion of magic. Now, what you just saw in my living room with the lasers and bending light and waking up the neighbors, that's actually just a section from my stage show where I bend light like a solid object. But I got a treat for you today. I'm gonna show you how to bend light, and it won't be a trick. And you can do it with the stuff you can find in your kitchen. How cool is that? Now, we've learned about refraction before, where light will bend, and we did it with other episodes where we can bend light around an object to turn the object invisible. We also learned that light will travel in a straight line till it hits a new medium, where it will bend, and then it will travel in a straight line in that new medium, where it will travel till it hits another new medium, and it bends again. That's great, but in this mixture, it seems to be curving. So what's going on? Well, it turns out refraction has two major ingredients. The first is the angle in which light enters the new medium. And the second is optical density. So let me explain. The angle in which light enters a new medium and how it affects refraction is pretty easy to understand. Imagine a marching band representing a ray of light. All of them are marching in formation in a straight line across a field. And if they all encounter a new medium like mud at the same time straight on, well, they all slow down at the same time, so there's no change in direction. But if they encounter mud at an angle, one side of the band slows down, while the rest of the band keeps marching along, causing the formation to turn. So the angle of this new incidence determines how much quicker one side of the group will encounter the new medium versus the other. So the angle affects refraction. The second part is the optical density, or refractive index. It's how fast or slow light will travel through a new medium. Think of it as the type of mud they're marching through. Light mud versus swamp thick mud. The more dense the mud, the harder it is to march, the steeper the turn. So you can see why angle and optical density affect refraction. All right, so what's the secret ingredient? Sugar water. Seriously, just regular sugar water. But the secret is not what is it. The secret is how it's made. See, we need the bottom to be more optically dense than the top. And that comes from how we're gonna make this mixture. So this is a 10-gallon fish tank, so I ended up using 4 pounds of sugar with roughly 3 gallons of water. And if you have a smaller aquarium or a tank, you can use 2 pounds of sugar with 1.5 gallons of water. Now, first what you need to do is you need to pour the sugar into the container and you want to flatten it out so that it's even across the bottom as best as you can make it. If you find any clumps, make sure you break them up, pat it down flat. Then you need to pour your water in, but you don't want to disturb the sugar in the middle of the aquarium. So you want to pour along the sides. Now I used a piece of plastic to actually pour the water in so that it would flow against the glass. That way the center stays roughly undisturbed. Now comes the hardest step. You need to wait 2 to 3 days. It takes forever, especially when you know how cool this is gonna be. But what happens is the sugar is actually dissolving into the water from the bottom up, making a more dense material on the bottom than it is on the top. And we can't touch the aquarium once it starts dissolving because we don't wanna accidentally mix it. And for this experiment, you're gonna need a laser. Now you can use a pen laser at home, but because I'm using cameras, I wanted you guys to be able to see it, so I'm using my own laser. And of course, since we're using lasers, you're gonna want some protective eyewear. Now, lasers are extremely dangerous, so don't point them in your eyes, or anyone else's eye for that matter. By letting the water sit for 2 days, the sugar slowly dissolves up into the water, but it also creates a mixture where the water closer to the bottom of the aquarium has a higher optical density of sugar than the rest of the water in the tank. This change in density leads to a change in refraction. A change in refraction creates a change in the way light travels through it, making it bend. This material has a gradient in optical density, which causes a gradient in refraction, which is why we see a curve. As you can see, near the top, the laser passes straight through the aquarium, but as we move our laser closer to the bottom, we can see how the laser bends and actually curves down. Bending light turns out to be one of those subjects that always sounds impossible, and yet it's totally possible through science. And there's a lot of different ways to do it other than sugar water. And if you're curious about what those are, let me know in the comments below. I'm happy to try to put some experiments together so that we can actually see different ways to bend light. And if you enjoy making the impossible possible through science, let me know by clicking the like button and subscribing to the channel. And make sure you turn on those notifications so that you know the next time I'm gonna wake up my neighbors with a laser light show. Until next time, stay curious, because the right question changes everything.